I want to continue to our talk with the superstitious belief in the Eastern superstitious Eastern religions. We know karma, it is an erroneous belief
Yes.
that has a very important place in these superstitious Eastern religions such as Buddhism, Hinduism or Jainism. And some circles try to give an example and show try to show these religions that these superstitious religions actually have mysterious and supposed amazing features. But these people's interesting costumes, shaven heads, senseless rituals and the places they live and some practices like yoga, meditation, they all attract a number of people's interest. And in addition, these superstitious faiths are portrayed as paths to the salvation. But we know that they have no such qualities, of course. And actually they lead people into darkness. For example, Hindus falsely imagine that they can be purged of their sins by washing in the river Ganges. And Buddhists ignorantly prostrating themselves before statues of Buddhas and even offering them food. And it is also a very ridiculous act that they do
yes.
because these statues of Buddha has no mouth, has no sense.
Yes.
To taste any kinds of foods.
Yes.
This is this even only this example shows how superstitious is these
yes.
religions.
Because it is stone or wooden or metal.
Yes.
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 And just in these kinds of religions, superstitious religions, children raised in darkness environments, and also they cut off from the outside world. Superstitious Eastern religions lead people to a terrible pessimism, and these people live in fear, restlessness, and also anxiety of thinking that everything in the earth can be randomly, happens randomly. And in searching for peace and happiness, these people turn into miserable souls who place their faith in some stone idols, as we mentioned before.
Yes.
And there is no faith in hereafter. And also in superstitions, faith, that believe in karma, they believe that people will return to earth again and again. This is also another error of these religions.
Yes.
In other words, they believe in reincarnation. And the error of reincarnation comes from the philosophy of karma. It is remarkable that these people, I know most of you know this fact, they think that they were a princess or a king
yes.
or a Native American in their supposed past life. No one thinks that he was or she was a dog in their
yes.
before in their past lives. They always thinking these kinds of royal lives, royal
yes.
lifestyles they deserve. Of course, everyone deserves, but this example shows that how erroneous this religion is also. And maybe they believe that this transition also will go on forever. And examination of the verses in the Quran, however, shows that this faith is a serious misunderstanding because people will not come back to life and return to earth as claimed in the superstitious belief in karma and reincarnation. Life is only this world, life of this world will come to an end, to a sudden end with death, of course.
Yes.
And like all billions of people, whoever lived, everyone around us, the friends, relatives, and everyone in the earth will one day die. And after that, it is the life of the hereafter that will begin and not a new life in the world that they claim. In the Quran, Allah reveals this fact. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. Then when the death comes to one of you, our messengers take him and they do not fail in their task. Then they are returned to Allah, their master, the real. Jurisdiction belongs to him alone and he is the swiftest of reckoners. Surat An'am verses 61 and 62. Mm-hmm.
And many people, as you said, don't really, they are really unaware of what in fact is karma and reincarnation. According to the philosophy of karma, whatever someone has done in the past, he will experience the same thing in the future. So if you do bad thing in the past, mm-hmm. you will experience bad things in the future, which is very funny
yes.
and
childish.
Very childish.
Yes.
Philosophy.
Mm-hmm.
We know that it is not true. You may do something bad in the past, but when you believe in Allah and you change yourself, yes, you can experience good things, of course, and you can expect good things from Allah for the future, inshallah.
Inshallah. And they think that human beings, as we mentioned, constantly return to earth and experience the consequences, as Sister Zeynep mentioned, of their deeds in the previous life or in their next life. And they believe that if someone is wealthy or successful in this life, then he is being rewarded for having been a good person in his or her previous life.
And in the same way, if someone is poor or unsuccessful, then he was a bad person in the past and in his previous life, and is being punished for this.
Yes. And one of the main difficulties in karma is the question of under whose control this mythical process takes place. In other words, what is the power and force that decides whether a person is good or whether a person is bad? And what form he will return in his future life. We need there should be a power to decide this, as they believe. And the answers to these questions reveal that the idea of karma is nonsense because, according to its supporters, the process is a totally uncontrolled one. And the fact is, though, that belief in karma and reincarnation is completely mistaken. Yes. And it is also frankly revealed in the Quran that nobody will be able to come back to this life after their death. And Allah mentions this in the Quran: I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. Give from what we have provided for you before death comes to one of you, and he says, my Lord, if only you would give me a little more time so that I can give charity and be one of the righteous. Allah will not give anyone more time. Once their time has come, Allah is aware of what you do. Surat Al-Munafikun, verses 10 and 11. Human beings come to life by being given a soul by Allah, and die when the appointed hour comes. After that, it is the life of the hereafter that begins, and not a new life of this world. And Allah tells us about death and resurrection in the Quran also. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. How can you reject Allah? When you were dead and then he gave you life, then he will make you die and then give you life again. Then you will be returned to him. Surat Al-Baqarah, verse 28. Some people change the obvious meaning of this verse and misinterpret the Quran as pointing to reincarnation. And this misinterpretation may sometimes come from a hidden agenda or sometimes from a failure to understand the Quran properly due to lack of knowledge. But these verses of the Quran we have examined and read clearly prove that there is but one life of this world and one death at the end of it. So there is no returning to the world after that. And it is the life of hereafter that this time begins. And the meaning of the verse is also really crystal clear for all of us. Allah reveals that at the beginning a human being is dead. And in other words, the basis of human creation is earth. And Allah says in the Quran that he created man from mud, as we all know. At a specific time after that life, the person again becomes lifeless when that life comes to an end, and he decays and becomes dust. This is the second time that a person has been dead, and all that remains is the final resurrection, and the resurrection in the hereafter. And in conclusion, we can briefly say that from this verse, that there is one life of this world. And at the end of it, one passes to the hereafter. It is also clear that it does not mean a resurrection and the returning to the world time and time again after that. In other verses, Allah also reveals that a person will taste death only one time. Allah says that I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. They will not taste any death there except for the first one. He will safeguard them from the punishment of the blazing fire, a favor from your Lord. That is the great victory. Surat Ad-Dukhan. Verses 56 and 57, Allah clearly reveals that in this verse we will taste death only one time, and superstitious beliefs such as karma are no solution for happiness or pleasant life as they claim. And the living conditions and injustice in those countries in which these religions are widespread or even sometimes regarded as the national religion, they are some of the clearest examples of this fact. The solution of people's troubles to everything they wish to put right is to be found in the Quran, Elhamdulillah. In the Quran, Allah reveals that it is He who frees human beings from trouble, not these kinds of superstitious beliefs, superstitious religions. In the Quran, Allah reveals that it is He who frees human beings from trouble. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. Say, Allah rescues you from it and from every plight. Then you associate others with Him. Surat Al-An'am, verse 64. The Quran is the, Alhamdulillah, only source to lead people to salvation that warns them about the eternal life that follows death and that shows them the true path and acts as a guide for all those seeking to win the approval, mercy and the paradise of Allah, inshallah. And most importantly, the religion of Islam revealed in the Quran as the sole faith appointed, the only faith appointed by the Allah. I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. If anyone desires anything other than Islam as a religion, it will not be accepted from him, and in the hereafter he will be among the losers. Surah Al-Imran, verse 85.